ask the members of the public who are still at the back, we're now going to reconvene the meeting, so can you please either talk outside or take a seat if you're going to listen to the rest of the meeting, please. Thank you. Thank you. Right, we'll... Right, members, we've got a couple of our groups still missing, but I'm going to start, otherwise we'll be here all night. I did say 5 minutes, and I gave well over 5 minutes. Right, we're back now to item number 4 on the agenda. Both made, so please can you take your seats as quickly as possible. Thank you. Can we close that door, please? Can you close that door, Phil, please? Okay. I did say 5 minutes, and it's now nearly 10. Right, we're back to the agenda. We're now back down to item number 4. So I'll invite Councillor Phil Davies. Phil's here, if we can all remember, at our last meeting there was a notice of motion, and it was felt Phil was down in London, and it was asked that we deferred to this meeting. So over to you, Phil, thank you.
Thanks, Chair, and thanks for the invitation to talk to the notice of motion which was referred by the Mayor to this committee on inward investment. And I want to just talk about the work that we're doing to bring additional investment and jobs to Wirral from the Far East, particularly from China. I don't need to tell anybody in this room how important China is in terms of a global economy. And, it's one of the interesting characteristics of the political scene at the moment that you had the president of China extolling the virtues of free trade at the financial summit in Davos, at the same time as the new American president was talking about protectionism. I thought that was one of life's supreme ironies. But on a serious note, for the last, I guess, probably 6-7 years now, we've been very proactive as a council and as a borough, really, in terms of trying to attract business in China. And certainly, I've been to China a number of times. I've been with leaders of all parties on this council. It's China, Jeffrey, a number of times with Tom Harney when he was leader of the Liberal Democrats. Because I think we all of us recognise across political parties that it's a massive economy, 1.4 billion population, and they have a enthusiasm really to. Doing deals, trade deals with the UK, and I think it's important that we put our best foot forward as a borough, but also as a city region. What I just want to do is give a flavour of the latest delegation that we had, which went out last October, early November, which was probably the biggest delegation that's been from the city region, and it was also the first time that we'd gone as a Liverpool city region. So I went along with Joe Anderson there at Liverpool, but we also had about 9 or 10 businesses from the city region there. We had three from Wirral. We had Wirral Chamber of Commerce go with us, and also Liverpool Vision, who do the promotion and marketing of the city region. And it was a very intensive trip that, that covered six cities in China. And the, if I just give you a very brief sort of outline of the kind of economies we're dealing with. So we started in the southwest of the country in a city called Kunming. And just when I tell you the population of these areas is mind-blowing. So Kunming is 6.2 million. We then went on to Chongqing, which is 36 million. It's the biggest city in the world. It's the size of Austria. That's in central China. And then we went up to the north to Tianjin, which is 14 million. The capital, Beijing, which is 18 million. Chandao, which is 6.1 million. And then we finished off in Shanghai, which is 34 million. And just out of Shanghai is Taichung, which is our sister city, Wirral's sister city. So the scale of these economies are, you know, is truly enormous. In terms of what activity we did, we basically went as a civic and business delegation, and the aim was to do deals really for business and trade. And with all of these things in China, often it's not an instant result, it's a slow, what we call a slow burn, so it's about building up relationships with civic leaders, with other businesses. And in all of these cities, we did a kind of presentation to the government of the city and businesses. And our businesses then had what they call kind of matchmaking sessions with other businesses from that region to explore whether they, you know, could develop a commercial kind of partnership. And I mean, I haven't got time to kind of take you through the whole program, but suffice to say that somewhere in the region of 102 leads were generated as a result of the visit and are currently being kind of proactively followed up. A high proportion, which is really good to hear, a high proportion of these leads were very interested in Wirral and in the opportunities that we have in Wirral around some of our key sectors, low carbon, offshore wind, some of the advanced manufacturing companies like Unilever, etc. They're very interested in the enterprise zone. We had Peel with us, representatives from Peel, so they were able to talk about the advantages and the incentives for locating in an enterprise zone. Our businesses also had some really productive meetings with other businesses, and deals were done while we were out there, which is heartening. But just to focus specifically on what we're following up on Wirral, so if I just give you a few examples. So we, the region of Chongqing, this region of 30 odd million, we've signed a memorandum of understanding while we were there with the government of Chongqing, and they're very interested in looking in Wirral at automotives, vocational training and healthcare as kind of key sectors that they would like to send businesses over to us from China and encourage our businesses to look at opportunities in Chongqing, and we're following up that now. In terms of other specific companies, we had there was a very large cable manufacturing company that was very interested in the opportunities around offshore wind. They produce cables for the wind turbines, and they're very interested in partnering with us. And in fact, they're sending a delegation over to Wirral in April, May time of this year. They're keen to set up a manufacturing operation around renewables, and they see Wirral as a preferred location, which I think is really good. They are, done the due diligence. They are a significant company employing, several hundred people with a multi-million pound turnover. So they're not a, they're not a trivial company by any means. So that, actively expressing interest in Wirral that we're pursuing are two manufacturing businesses, one in Shanghai, one in Tianjin, who are interested in locating with the maritime and energy park on Wirral waters. So that's being followed up. And other export opportunities have been developed by Wirral Chamber and Mersey Maritime, the umbrella organisation for maritime industries. Joe Anderson and I also met a major investor based in Beijing who is interested in investing in a whole range of projects, not just in Wirral, but throughout the city region. I can't go into kind of details because we're in kind of negotiations with them, but if that comes off, that will be a really landmark deal for, as I say, for the whole city region, because they are looking at a whole portfolio of projects across both Liverpool, Wirral, and other parts of Liverpool city region. The other thing, just to say, as well as obviously businesses, we also had some city region-wide businesses who went out. So, for example, the operations director from Liverpool, John McLachlan, was in the delegation. Now, he had some really productive meetings. One of the cities I mentioned, Changdao, which is 6 million, he got into a very interesting conversation with the government there, who are keen to develop direct flights from Changdao to Liverpool John Lennon, which again, given that size, that economy, you know, opens up all sorts of possibilities for both trade, tourism, and so on and so forth. We had a senior executive from Liverpool John Moores University. Some of you may know that Liverpool John Moores University have got a big project around sensors, producing sensors for a whole range of different industries. And they have, again, negotiations around doing a partnering arrangement with one of the cities we visited there to do a partnership around sensors. I could go on, but I'm just trying to give you a kind of flavour of the work we did while we were over there. I think suffice to say is I think the fact that we went as a city region, that we presented a kind of united front between politicians, businesses, and officials from our local government, I think was really, really impressive. Particularly, you know, when you look at the scale of these economies, you know, Liverpool City Region is 1.5 million, but compared to some of these cities I've mentioned, you know, it's actually quite a small city region. And what I think that kind of hit home to me is the more we can present a kind of holistic offer, if you like, from the whole of the city region, rather than just bits of it, I think the more likely we are to get that investment and those jobs over the line. The feedback that we've had since we came back is that it has raised our profile, not just as well as the region, in terms of opportunities in China. This is the feedback we've had from, we work quite closely while we're over there with the British Embassy, the British Consulate, who obviously we've got official civil servants based out there permanently, and we had really good feedback from those guys that, you know, the work we did while we were over there was very well received, and has put us ahead of the pack, actually, because a lot of this investment is very competitive. Other parts of the UK are also going out there, so we're in a very competitive kind of environment. So we had good feedback about how we were received. And as I said, there were some 102 leads being followed up, and I think a very high likelihood that we will get some investment and jobs here. I think the final thing to say is that on the businesses side, you know, the three Wirral businesses, the feedback we've had, they were very, very, they thought it was a very useful investment of their resources and their time. So much so that the Chamber has reported back to us that 12 additional businesses, not the three that went, 12 new businesses who not been to China before, have signed up to participating in a future delegation. So I think businesses in Wirral, businesses in the city region, see the value of making these of these visits. So I think still a lot of work is ongoing around these 100 odd leads, but I think the indications in the sort of 3 or 4 months that we've been back is that it has been a useful investment of our time and our resources. And obviously, I'm very happy to kind of give further reports as these leads are followed up, and hopefully we land some of these deliveries. So that's basically a kind of summary of the of what we did while we were there. Happy to take any questions, Chair.
Okay, I'll I always start over on the right because I tend to go to the right. So I will
proposals for indigenous communities in big cities like Manchester, London.
I don't know the detail of the Chinatown investment, but I know, you know, speaking to Jamison, he has sort of waxed lyrical about the scale of that, but I'm not aware of the kind of detail. On the two sectors you mentioned, I mean, tourism, I think you mentioned that with the operations director of Liverpool, John Moore's airport, sorry, John Moore's airport, John Lennon Airport, it's been a long day, John Lennon Airport is talking about a direct air route to Liverpool, which I think opens up the tourism market, you know, for a population of 6 million. You know, when you think it's kind of almost the size of Greater London, it's amazing, really. In terms of creative industries, we did look at quite an interesting creative industries course in Beijing, and we kind of hooked up with the guys who were in charge of that, and again there are links that have been made with them, so I think there are possibilities there as well.
Thank you very much, Chair. Yeah, I fully support all the work that's been done in relation to this and trying to get people involved. Members, I do remember when we had the last major storms on the road, it was when I was in there and I had to invite the Chinese Council to have a look at the convention. And sad to say, it was an awful day, but I did manage to take the gentleman around to other places. Now the thing is, as much as business and all these other issues are important, you've got to realise the regime that runs that particular country. And I think, as an authority, we should... I invited him because he didn't know where the Wirral was. That really surprised me, considering the amount of work we do as an authority to try and promote ourselves in Ghana. I was at the Chinese New Year programme over in Liverpool. That's it. The opportunity as the mayor of the long minutes to meet the council, and I invited him when I realised he didn't know what it was. Pleased to say enjoyed it, even though it was a horrendous day. I was able to take him to the multicultural centre for a couple of hours, which was very important to him and his people, and it's good for the world. I'm fully supportive of all the actions being done, but I do have reservations because we still have a poster in Committee Room 3 from a Chinese lady who was going to come and do some major developments in rural waters, which doesn't exist anymore. But her name is still up on the wall, statue. I mean, we've got to be careful in what we do. I'm fully supportive of going out in the right way. We only got to look at what the investments that are taking place around Manchester Airport, simply because of the contact with Chinese governments and the developments that are taking place there. So, you know, we see what we can do. We make sure that we get it right.
Just a comment on one of the things that they were saying, you know, the Chinese Council didn't know where it was. What became really clear, it was quite interesting really, because of the scale of these cities that we've been visiting, actually, you know, the distinction between kind of Liverpool and Wirral, for the size of the cities we're talking about, they, you know, it was a kind of common characteristic of those cities that often there was a kind of there was a major river running through the city and there were both sides back. They did differentiate between either side of the river. It was one conurbation, one economy. And I think sometimes we can get quite parochial in our world. And actually, what this visit said to me is we need to, that's why we do need to promote Wirral as part of the Liverpool City region, because our businesses and our residents crisscross the river that they every day to go to work, to go to, you know, to learn, etc. And I think the scale of what we saw in China says actually, you know, we need to continue to kind of break down those barriers between Wirral and the other side. So that was an interesting.
I couldn't agree more there about navel gazing and the work that Anita and I do on the Liverpool City Region Scrutiny Committee. We have really got to come more and more together, and I hope we are, and we are doing that, I think, through the the six regions, we are working closer and closer together, and I really do welcome that. Thanks, Phil. Tom.
Chair, thank you. The leader actually for the feedback, it really is very interesting, and to commend him actually for all the work he does. It is important to go out en masse as part of the city region and businesses and understand about what Dave says, you know, coming into fruition, but it will take time. It's a slow burner, and the only thing that you can do, you can do as an authority, is to keep building those relationships, forging new ones. So I do welcome everything that the leader's done and thank him for it. Just on his notice of motion, in fact, it's something I'd really like to support, actually, but unfortunately, the second paragraph states about the government's lack of enthusiasm for the Northern Powerhouse. Now, I understand this was written quite a long time ago, and it probably hasn't alluded the leader that the Prime Minister yesterday announced another £556 million for the Northern Powerhouse, which I think everyone in this room would welcome. Would that be something that the paragraph the leader be something willing to withdraw?
I mean, a lot of that money, without getting into any controversial waters here, a lot of that money is not is ELVF money that's been kind of recycled. But look, you know, I welcome any funding, additional funding that goes into the city region, the Northern Powerhouse. If anything, my criticism of the government is they need to speed up the pace of devolution. And devolve more powers and crucially the funding to go over the powers from Whitehall to the city region. And I think unfortunately, and this is not a pillars of comment, it's actually just an observation. I think the whole of the civil service, this is a generalisation, but I do believe this, I think the whole of the civil service and a lot of ministers are actually so diverted now by Brexit that the devolution momentum has slowed. There's no question about that. So I hope that we can, you know, put our foot on the accelerator again and really continue to make the case that actually decisions made by people who live and work and represent people in the city region are better than Whitehall. We need to, I think, lobby the government. I think we can do that across parties to say, you know, let's have more powers devolved to so that would be my criticism. We need to really kind of re-energise the whole debate. I think it was championed by George Osborne and David Cameron. I think because those two now people are out of the picture, I think I do detect a it's not given as much priority, and I think Brexit has not. So that would be my observation about how we can, how we can really kind of move forward together on an agenda that will help us as well as other city regions in the
Chris, and then Ron.
Thanks, Chairman. I too would like to thank Phil for his comprehensive report back there, and thank him for the work he does for the council, for the people of Wirral. You don't always see eye to eye politically, but he has a role. And he carries out that role very well, I believe.
previously. So we've made these points to both the Secretary of State for local communities and local government and the Minister for the Northern Powers. My only observation, again, it's Chair, it's not a political point, but I find it frustrating, I think, as a councillor, that yes, I think we have got some positive, and I'll give credit where credit's due. I think government has done the right thing about the devolution. I think it's the right agenda. However, I can't ignore the fact that in another part of the universe, in terms of local government budgets, just had a debate about, can talk about numbers, but unfortunately, because of our budget here in the council being cut, we are absolutely having to be forced to focus on the economic development agenda, because that's the only place we're going to get money going forward, business rates and council tax receipts. So if the government were as positive and as forthcoming on the devolution, if they were as positive and forthcoming on funding of local government as they were on devolution, we have a win-win situation. But unfortunately, yes, we are thinking of doing some really innovative stuff on jobs and investment. But on the other hand, our social care system is on the brink of collapse. Now, that's got to be an issue that we're concerned about. So I'll give credit where credit's due, but it's, if you look at the totality of the needs of the people of Wirral, I'm afraid there are areas where the government have got some serious questions to answer. So that would be my take.
If we take that to the end, we all agree with social care. I think you said council. We agree with you. I will defend the government when I defend it, but I can't defend the government over social care. I said with the council, I'll say it again there. I think they have got it wrong the way they've gone about it. I do think there has to be a radical influx of money, and then a look longer term at how we get that right. But that's clearly separate to your intervention, which was, in all fairness, written in October, Phil, when those learnings might have been a bit more relevant than they are today. And I just think we should be all working together to try and push the government to bring this forward quick. And I just think sending a positive message is a far better way than negative.
Okay. Ron.
Thank you, Chair. I'm going to commend the council leader who has a backhanded comment as well, that goes along with the commending. But I'd just like to point out that I think work that the leader does and the leaders in the city region is vital, because we are in the process of negotiating, or we will be in March, negotiating our removal from the European Union, which means the single market. The moment the single market is worth £382 billion to the British economy, £29 billion is a drop in the ocean to that. When you think about it, we're going to have to fill a gap. America will not fill that gap. America, we don't do business with America, of £82 billion. So it's more and more important that we open up markets that actually give us the trade. And the work that we've done over a number of years is opening up the trade market, which for a long, long time, since the days of Marco Polo, has been a closed shop. And that's the issue now, is the culture has changed. China is coming into the modern world and want to be part of the modern world. And it's about that, how do we interact with huge economies like that. The next economy that we need to be interacting with more is the Indian economy, which is another growing economy. While we're contracting, the rest of the world is the third world countries, as they were called at that time, are expanding, and they're the market we need to be in. We've got to fill the book void somewhere or other. If we don't do trade with Europe, which I think we might find difficult to do in the future on post-Brexit, we're going to have to look for the alternative trade mechanisms that we can actually do. And I think the work that the city region do, and all the businesses do, is highly commended, because it actually does bring some rewards to us, and we hope in the long term will bring greater rewards that will actually solidify and create more jobs than we've got in the moment. Government policy will not do that alone, because government policy is tearing away from these countries and not engaging these countries. It's about engaging
overwhelming.
Mike, can I just make comment? Well, and again, I don't want to kind of continue the argument, but whilst the money that was announced yesterday was welcome, I remain disappointed about the lack of movement on some of the big ticket infrastructure challenges that we got in the north. So, for example, I think the government has missed a huge opportunity by not announcing a high-speed HS2 high-speed rail link into Liverpool city centre, into Lime Street, because that, at a stroke, would open up fantastic opportunities to get freight, not just passengers, but freight out of the port of Liverpool on, to the national network. And I was disappointed, frankly, in the Chancellor, Philip Hammond, in the autumn statement. He had an opportunity to announce that as a major flagship scheme. I mean, and also the other big opportunity, a big infrastructure sort of weakness we've got is links from from the west to the east, from Liverpool across the Hull, otherwise known as HS3, or Transport for the North. Again, that is, anybody who's tried to get on a train to go from Liverpool to Hull, it takes forever. And surely, if there's any piece of infrastructure that's crying out for, renewal and upgrading, it's that. And what did, I listened to Chancellor's speech, he announced the biggest spend in his autumn statement was a 25 million piece of infrastructure from Oxford to Cambridge. Now, it's really just an observation that I do think the government need to, notwithstanding what was announced yesterday, if they could address these big problems we've got with our infrastructure, high-speed rail link into Liverpool City, and a high-speed rail link across from Liverpool through Manchester, Leeds, Newcastle, Hull, I think that would then say to me, they're taking the North seriously, but I'm not seeing those big ticket schemes coming forward. Now, hopefully they will in the future, but thus far, there's been more words, but there's been no hard cash put up by government. So that's what I was trying to get at in that paragraph.
Well, thank you. And I think Chris, that you made a fair comment there about that paragraph, but I think the leader of the council has more than answered that, and I would hope that we can have all cross-party support for this. Chris, I'm going to bring Anita in now. But I think the leaders have answered that more than adequately. So, again, I'll say, I would hope for this motion, notice of motion, we can get all party support, perhaps. Anita.
Thanks, Chair. I'd like to fully support the motion and welcome any new money investment and job creation, as well as tourism opportunities for Wirral and the wider Liverpool City region. Locally, I'm aware of a business who's benefited from this trip to China, and also I'd like to congratulate Phil and the officers on the successes that they've made today.
Thanks, Anita. Thank you. Anybody else? Tom?
Sure, just quickly, I would support the HS2 line coming into Liverpool. I would lobby government for that. I think the 20-mile mm-hmm. campaign is excellent. I would support HS3 across the board. And in fact, go further, if you look in London in the central line, mm-hmm. to get across it, it's 45 mm-hmm. minutes. That would take us from straight from Liverpool to Leeds. But that's not going to happen overnight. It's going to take time. It's going to take lobbying. And we're not going to get the whole proportion of what we want, which is spread around the country. So, I'm with you on that one, Phil. But still, this paragraph, I just think it's a bit... it could be reworded in my colleague Councillor Blakeley said, and then I'll be happy to support.
Would you like to make any further
comments? No,
I think he more than covered that. Okay. Phil, I'd like to thank you for making the time on our vision role, for coming along tonight. And from all the committee, I'd like to thank you. Say journey home.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right, it's quite simple now. The committee can either accept this notice of motion, reject the notice of motion, or amend the notice of motion.
Thank you, Chair. I would, as I outlined, I would like Council Government's commitment to its flagship regeneration policy in all the powers, and one of the country council, along with all other authorities in the region, to meet with the Minister for Northern Powers, Andrew Percy MP, in order to explore all options to drive economic success. The rest of the motion stays with the Deputy.
Are you seconding that? I'm not sure. Thank you. Dave?
I did have the end of the first, but then
I'm sorry, Dave. I didn't
That's see okay. You.
Sorry.
I suffer concern from
the.
Actually had our second meeting now, and we are due to